Hi, we're Extreme. I'm Gary.
I'm Luno.
I'm Paul.
And I'm Pat.
Nightmare.
The first record was a Frankenstein nightmare. So this one just happened so smoothly, we can't even believe it's done right now.
Doing it over and over and over, getting it exactly right.
We didn't do that, as you can tell.
When you do that, you lose the life of the song itself.
Tell you a little bit about the new video.
Paul, tell them about the new video.
Are you the decadent drummer? Is that you?
I am the decadent. Watch this.
Wow.
Give him your side view.
Wow, dude. Very low profile. The new video, we wanted to stay with performance, right?
He has a pretty good sized member for a man his size. The song is called Decadence Dance, and it kind of pokes fun at that whole censorship thing that's going on right about now, and it's pretty funny.
And it got censored, so it worked.
What's your take on this whole censorship thing, since you sort of brought it up?
The girl in the blackness, fake boobs, where do you see it?
Absolutely taking this thing out of control. I hope that though I want to defend Judas Priest, they could have been listening. These kids could have been listening to Barry Manilow, and they still were going to kill themselves. And you know, if anything, you can't blame a rock band for that.
I remember it
well. I was just about three.
My dad said, "Son, what do you want
to be?"
No bells. I'm a bit too young for who you want from
me!
A little more guitar, please. Whatever chorus you have on the guitar, pull it back a little, because it's a little detuning. Tom, if that's you. Thank you.
that you love me, 'cause I'd already know. What would you do if my heart was torn in two? More than words to show you feel that you're. It's a good, it's a bad. I don't know. It's the worst version I've ever heard.
Yeah, everything's cool, right, Mars?
Yeah.
My guests today are Nuno Bettencourt, Gary Sharon of Extreme.
Extreme is music. It doesn't matter what kind of music it is. We're a hard rock and roll band.
A musical band, we just do what Extreme does. We can't, you know, we can't do anybody else better than we do us. You go through experiences. Some days you're happy, some days you're miserable. And, you know, everybody has that side to them, you know, they got that bitchy side.
The bands that apologize for their ballads are the ones that do it for money, and we do it for what comes out of our hearts.
The
just barely.
Just barely.
Guys, that's just, right. Just pulled into the driveway literally 3 minutes ago. What's up? How's it going? How's the ZZ Top tour?
It's ZZ Top. Great. No, it's been great. I mean, we just got off the Roth tour, and now we're doing the ZZ thing up until the end of September in Europe. But as far as playing in front of a new audience, it's ZZ Top audience.
Yeah.
Is it a different audience than a David Lee Roth Cinderella audience?
Yeah.
It's more of a
winning the audience over. With Roth and Cinderella, the crowd knew of us. With ZZ Top, it's an older crowd, and it's new.
Yeah,
for
the
us,
difference so. Is an extreme crowd, then there's a more than words crowd. You know, you get what I'm saying? Like, it's a very hit-orientated crowd, which is more of the ZZ thing. Then, with David Lee Roth, there was some kind of fan base. You know.
Oh, that's interesting. Yeah. So you're dealing with more of a more than words.
Yeah, we're winning him over. You know, when more than words comes up, it's like it's a different audience.
There's a lot of people.
Then we go away.
A lot of people come up to us and goes, "You're the guys that do that more than words song right there." We like that song. We don't like any of the other songs.
Oh, dear.
No, they don't really say that.
They like a
they just give us the finger and...
The saga of the opening act, it have everyone goes through it, I guess, at one time or another. We have half-hour phone calls. Heather, my friend Heather from Everett, Washington, has been calling since, 1 o'clock this afternoon. Heather, you're finally on.
Hi.
Oh.
How are you doing?
Great. How you doing?
Pretty good. Okay, I have two questions for you. First, I want to know, do you know who you'll be touring with after ZZ Top, and have you guys thought about doing a live album?
I'll answer the first question.
Okay.
What was the first question? When we finished ZZ, we finished in September. We have, they're giving us actually 2 days off, I heard, I think.
Wow.
Yeah, it's Christmas.
You'll relax.
And then we go to Europe, November, and then we end in Japan in December, and then take Christmas off, and we're doing a new record next year.
When you go over to Europe, is this also a ZZ Top?
Or? No, we're headlining ourselves. We went there a couple of months ago, and we did so well that going back and doing our own little tour there.
Can I answer the first question again?
And the second question was about the live album, I believe.
I think live albums are not a thing of the past, but just a live record as far as without a video is no more. I think it's just a package altogether. If we did something live, it would be a film, like a concert film, along with maybe a soundtrack to that. But just doing a live record, I don't know.
Yeah, we've learned that, even by hearing stuff on tape, that... being a performance band, and loving to perform, it's a different vibe when you're playing and you get something from the audience. When you record it on tape, you don't feel the same thing. It's not just an audio thing, it's a visual, it's both of them together. And it's an excitement you get live that you can't, no matter what anybody tells you, you will not capture it on record. Like they tell you in the studio, we played live in the studio, and that's not true, because there were no people that you get a really... sense of an aura when you play in front of people.
Well, you've been a wonderful contestant, Heather, and thank you for playing. You bet your
tell
life.
Them what they won, Gary.
Thank you very much, Heather. We're going to go over to Nags Head, North Carolina, where Michelle is waiting on the phone. Hi, Michelle. What's your question?
Hi. It seems like the press is focused on Gary and Nuno more than the whole band, and I was wondering how that affected the rest of the band.
We're looking for a new bass player.
Oh, no, you're not.
No, just a joke. No, those guys... It's always, you got to understand, we, on the road, we separate the press, when it comes to interviews, phoners, we let them do the phoners, and all the magazines. It's just that, me and Gary being the writers, we write the majority of the stuff, we tend to have better,
more
better...
focal point, but we make it a point to bring them out as much as possible, but tell you the truth, we were swamped, in Europe and in America, when More Than Words hit with the press. But they don't want to do it.
They love. The answer is they love us doing the press. Trust me. We know where we're at as a band. Once you see the band live, you'll get the picture. That's all. Pretty much the answer should be.
Well, that was an interesting question.
Yeah, they
Thank
hold
you,
their
Michelle.
Own.
Very good question.
Chrissy is calling from Hammond, Indiana, with her question. Chrissy, welcome to Rockline.
Hi guys. How you doing?
Okay.
Good.
Now that we've heard from you, Chrissy, where have you been?
Excuse me. I couldn't hear that.
Sorry. Go ahead.
It's hard to hear you. Okay, I want to say first, okay, Nuno, I think you're the hottest guy I've ever seen in my whole life. I just wanted to make sure I got to tell you that, okay?
Okay, that's really my sister. I told her to call and say that. Thanks, sis. I really appreciate it. Now, we got to get back to the show.
Okay. I have two questions. First of all, Nuno, what is the N4 on your guitar? And second of all, how do you guys feel about the crossover? because there's a lot of stations here that normally wouldn't play you guys, and then as soon as More Than Words came out, and then that's all they play, but they won't play anything else. Does that bother you, or?
I'd rather answer. Gary will answer 3 and 4 on my guitar.
Well, the question was pointed to him, so I really didn't even hear it.
No, well,
you were just in a daydream.
You got to understand, as far as More Than Words goes, you know, a lot of people are telling us, Jesus, how do you feel about, it's the ballad thing, you know, how do you feel about a ballad breaking the band? It doesn't matter if it's a ballad or a rocker. I mean, that More Than Words is a side of us just as much as Get the Funk Out is. We had released Decadence, we had released Funk, but, you know, sometimes, you got to understand, More Than Words is, a lot more people can relate to it, and I think it hit home, you know, at a certain time, and it was timing, and you're never going to know extreme in one song. It's going to take a few songs because I think we have a lot of diverse stuff. So
I think that it also helped because there were people that knew you as being like a really hard mm-hmm. band, so that's an additional reason why More Than Words was really extra cool, because it was like, wow, it showed another side.
Yeah, because when we just came out, we were trying to get out of the heavy metal bin because they were throwing us into that, mm-hmm. and we never thought of ourselves as just being that. Mm-hmm. Though when we came out, you know, we were clumped in and like that.
Yeah. And we feel that More Than Words, you know, Mom goes out and buys More Than Words, right, for the record. She brings it home. She freaks out because she hears the other stuff. But then her son is listening and her daughter. They take that. And then Grandma comes in, puts on When I First Kissed You, and it's a family record.
Well, I don't know how many moms they're going to go. I mean, I know they all go to the store and say, that's lovely song, More Than Words. Then the album is called...
Pornograffiti.
See, but that's maybe I'll let my kids buy it.
I know, but that's the sad thing about people look at something and they get so afraid. When in reality, the record isn't about, you know, sex, drugs, and rock and roll. It's a view on pornograffiti is a term about, you know, sex on TV and sex everywhere else, how it's being used to sell everything. Now it's out of hand. From Club MTV, my favorite cameraman. Where is he?
We call it the cleavage cam.
Yeah, right.
Cleavage cam.
And more of that. We'll be back with Gary Nunu. The toll-free number here is 1-800-1-800-344-ROCK, and that's 1-800-344-7625. Our guest, Gary Sharon Nuno Betancourt of... Thank you.
Okay,
what?
$20 for that lesson.
Oh, yeah, I'll be writing you a check. Don't you worry about it. Welcome back to Rockline on MTV. Our guest today, Gary Sharon Nuno Betancourt of Extreme. You still have time to call us. Please do, 1-800-344-ROCK. And we totally forgot to answer the other half of Chrissy's question.
N4. The N4 is just, it's really actually simple. I just have four guitars, and that was my fourth one, and N stands for Nuno.
Really?
Yeah, and it's also, I have a guitar out on that Washburn puts out. It's the N4 model. It's a signature series.
So I know plugs.
Check it out. I'm plugging myself.
Okay. That you designed?
Yes.
That's pretty cool.
It's out, yeah.
Well, good. Mary is calling from Southampton, New Hampshire. Hi, Mary. What's your question?
Hi. I have two questions. I want to know if you guys still live in Boston, and where did you film your video, your new one?
The new one.
The new one. Gary?
The answer is yes. On both of those questions, we still live in Boston, and we did the video in Boston just before the Roth Cinderella tour.
Yes,
so it's got that old colonial type thing, George
it's
Washington
got that,
going through
Roxbury vibe.
Yeah.
Is it true that I heard a rumor that your first gig together was an Aerosmith tribute show?
Where'd you hear that?
Where did you get that
hey,
chunk of information?
The old Quinsky does her research.
Yeah, it's funny that you say that. That's how we met was. They had this thing in Boston where members from different bands get together and kind of on Halloween and do this tribute to the bands that they grew up on. And I had met Gary at this club, and we hooked up. And I knew Patrick from working at like this guitar shop. And Paul was already with Gary. Yeah. So we have pictures a year before the band was actually together of us together.
Doing
Aerosmith
and...
what's on?
Everything.
Back in the Saddle.
Back in the Saddle.
Everything.
Classics.
How priceless. Well, there you go.
We have pictures, too, but they're in a vault. And they'll never be revealed.
Yeah. She's got one right now.
Yeah.
Let's see it.
Let's move up to San Jose, California, where Sue is on the line waiting to speak with Gary Nuno. Hi, Sue. Go ahead.
Hi, Gary. Hi, Nuno.
How are you?
How you doing, Sue?
I'm doing fine. And
that's
you?
That's good. Very, very
we just
good.
Played in San Jose.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm really sorry, Gary, but this question is directed towards Nuno.
I'm leaving.
No, really, really.
Okay.
I give you
some
extra.
Well, I've heard recently that you got your hands insured with the Lloyd's of London company.
Oh, that's a deal with me.
And I was wondering, what does that cover and how much money is involved?
Well, the thing is this, is maybe we'll hook up later. And no, it's, I was just walking to the bus and my friend over here, Gary Cherone, thought I was looking at him when he was playing catch with one of our roadies, and I wasn't looking at him, but he thought I was saying, like, throw the ball with my eyes. So I turned away, and he whipped the ball, I mean, it landed on my hand. But it was all right until I got up the next morning, and I couldn't really move my fingers. So our super manager said, that's it, very upset that I was playing sports when I wasn't doing anything. So he sent me to my bunk in the bus, said I couldn't come off for 2 days, and he insured my hand. $5 million. Was it $5 million? Something like that.
Something like that.
But the other hand is still free, though. It's just, it's worth nothing.
And my throwing arm was insured for like $2. That's about it.
Well, thank you, Sue. That was a good question. Camille, Cedar Grove, New Jersey, go ahead. You're on.
Hi, guys. Hey,
Hi.
What about Club MTV? No.
Let's watch a few.
First of all, I just want to say you guys are great.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Thanks. Okay. This question is for Gary or Nuno. Okay. Did you decide to release Wholehearted as your second single to the success of More Than Words?
It's actually our fourth single, believe it
no,
or not.
No, I don't understand the question. We released it because of Wholehearted success?
Did you
no, because of More No, I know what you're saying. Actually,
More Than Words.
When we put up More Than Words, we want to... Our goal, a really important thing for this band is to really show, you know, a side of the band, which is Get the Funk Out. And Wholehearted is just like the next step to Get the Funk Out. You know, we didn't want to shock everybody right away. It brings in the whole band, and it's still a rocker, but it's an acoustic rocker. Get the Funk Out is really what we want everybody to see, because people are so afraid. You know, once they hear a ballad like that, they think that when a distorted guitar gets put on a song, they think it's like this heavy metal from hell thing, and everybody runs away screaming. When it's just like, it's just More Than Words, it's got melodies, but it's just a little harder, and you can groove to it, and right, Gary?
Yeah.
Did you record that in your bedroom, you know? Is that the story?
Not Wholehearted.
Were you there? No. It's just joking. Please don't kick me off the show. Yes. How did you... She knows her stuff.
She does her homework. This is...
We'll answer the questions.
Yes, actually, we have this thing...
in our bio.
We have this disease called demoitis, which sometimes you record a song that we're just writing and we demo it just to have it on tape so we can, you know, listen to it. And sometimes the magic is captured. And you try to recreate it when you go in the studio with all the great gear, and it just doesn't happen. So we kept a lot of the stuff right off of A-Track.
Called Beat the Demo.
Beat the Demo.
That's right.
We are here, Gary Cherone and Nuno Bettencourt. You're watching Rockline on MTV. They're here, and we're going to stick around for just a little bit longer. We'll be right back.
Got it. Hey, wait a minute. That's not Seaside Rendezvous by Queen.
It isn't?
Martha suggested it.
Oh, that was Get the
That's
Funk
what
Out
we're
by
play.
Extreme. Oh, Extreme. All those guys out of Boston.
Yeah.
Boston. Welcome back, Rockline on MTV.
Hey, we don't speak like the Kennedys. The Kennedys have their own thing happening, their own lingo, so relax.
Except for Schwarzenegger.
Grab some wood there, bub. Here we go.
Oh, excuse me? If you have
Hello?
A question for Nuno Bettencourt or Gary Cherone of Extreme, call us 1-800-344-ROCK. And that's 1-800-344-7625. If your call gets on the air, you get a box of 10 Sony Metal SR audio cassettes, courtesy of Sony Recording Media. Whoa! So, here we are. Everything okay?
Everything is
We're okay.
This is the last segment, so we got to make these
What's
good.
Is it going to be like a tearjerker ending? Do we have to play like...
Might be. Never know. Josh is going to start us off. Josh calling from Lantana, Florida. Go for it, Josh.
Hey. I was just wondering when you guys are recording your new album, and are you going to record it down here in Fort Lauderdale at the New River Studios?
Where do you get your information,
How
Josh?
Did you know?
He knows.
Talking to Martha.
Actually, we're going to be recording it. We're going to be finishing up our tour. In December, like the middle of December, we're going to take 2 weeks off for Christmas and start in January down
and you
in
are
Florida.
Going to, isn't
we're doing it in
just
Florida.
Yeah, they just did it.
Nice weather is all that counts, and a few wave runners. And,
we're from New England, and
we hate
our
winter.
Schedule is we record every winter, so.
So go someplace
We'll go someplace
warm.
Else.
Yeah,
Thank you, Josh. We're going to go to Lisa, who's calling from Philly, PA. Go for it, Lisa. Welcome to Rockline.
Hi. I just bought an Extreme picture disc with a song going to call A Nice Place to Visit. I just wanted to know if it was about anywhere in particular and how long ago you recorded it. And also, Gary, since we saw Nuno pumping iron on Entertainment Tonight, can you flex your muscles for us?
Oh, that's good.
People pay good money to see me flex during What was the question? I'm all embarrassed.
You flustered him now. He's like,
I'm flustered.
Is it picture disc?
The picture disc, nice place to visit.
Where is it about?
It's about a person.
It's actually about a girl. It's not about a place.
Who
nice
might,
place to visit, but I wouldn't
about?
Want to live her.
Who's it about?
An ex.
Oh. I'm sorry.
It hurts too much. It's too deep. And here you go, baby.
Woo! Very good.
That's it.
Aaron is calling from San Francisco, California, just up a bit. Actually, aren't you guys, were you just there? Are you going there?
We just played, we played San Jose, which is close.
Sort of near there.
Did with CZ Top, Steve Miller, Eric Johnson.
Stevie Guitar Miller. Aaron, what's your question?
Hi, I was wondering from your first demo, if you were going to do any songs on your new album, like Funky Little Holiday or anything.
Oh. Where are you from, bro?
Huh?
Where are you from? Where's he from?
San Francisco.
San Francisco.
I just moved here from Massachusetts.
I was going to say, where'd you get those tapes?
Yeah, where'd you get that tape? And I want it back.
What's this all about?
Just old demos.
Yeah, we get... just before the first record, just playing in Boston, like, for 3 years before we got signed, we did a lot of other songs. And they're on the shelf right now.
50 songs like catalogs.
Yeah, we're going to probably bring back some older songs, but one wasn't brought up.
Susie was an old one. You know, there's like two or three songs on Porno now that were like 6 years old. So there's always going to be like two or three closet classics.
Closet classics. You know, I wanted to ask you a question really quick. You have the address for Greenpeace.
Are you leaving this guy hanging?
Greenpeace.
No, we answered his question,
okay.
Didn't we?
Yes,
thank
we
you
did.
Very much for calling.
Wow.
Greenpeace, you have the address for Greenpeace on here. Tell me about that.
It's pretty much, we're just trying to be more aware of, not trying to hop on any bandwagon, because lately it seems like, you know, it's always like a hip thing. It's like censorship, you know, everybody, the people that do it, you know, talk about it for the right reasons, and there's people that hop on the bandwagon and they swear as much as they can on record so they can get attention and say that it's, you know, not cool to censor things. But as far as Greenpeace goes, it's just, I think a lot, it's really getting bad, and I think a lot of bands, you know, we've always believed that, you know, if we ever get a chance to make some money and get to a point where we can actually, people are listening to what we're saying and will listen to some advice, I think we got to start being aware of what's around us. I mean, I hate to preach. I'm not really preaching, but it's really getting out of hand. And especially rock bands, I think bands are in a position where these kids are listening to, you know, kids, whatever, adults, everybody's just listening for every word they're saying. And you should use it, you know, take time once in a while to be human and get off the rock trip and just talk to people about doing something, you know, get off your butts and do something.
It's just about making people aware of it, because we were just getting involved in it back then. And you figure, you know, a kid might go into a bookstore and he'll see something about Greenpeace, and then he'll relate it to Extreme. And if he's a fan, then he might get involved.
Definitely.
You know.
Definitely. That's a good thing. Bobby's calling from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Go ahead, Bobby. Ask your question.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Hey, Bob.
In your wholehearted video, why did you choose Cam Neely over Ray Bourque?
Cam Neely had a better hockey nose.
Yeah, and Larry Bird wasn't available.
No, it's just...
No.
A Bruin is a Bruin.
A friend. Yeah, he was a friend.
Yeah, he actually
Pat's, actually.
And there was another Bruin on there. Who was it? She's gone. Well, Gary, answer that question.
I really couldn't tell you.
But a Lyndon Bruin Bias. Is a Bruin.
A Bruin is a Bruin, and he will always be a Bruin.
That was the
as long as it was from, as long as he was from Boston.
Now, we have a call from Toledo, Illinois, and Katrina's on the line. Katrina, go ahead. Say hello to Gary and Nuno.
Hi, Gary. Hi, Nuno. You guys look really good.
Is it Toledo in Illinois?
Katrina? Yeah, Toledo, Illinois.
They were doing so well, and they opened up a new one in Illinois.
I read in the magazine that your younger brothers are in a band together called Flesh.
Uh-huh.
And I was wondering if you're trying to help them get a record deal or anything.
Listen,
no, because they're actually better than us.
And, see, we could have helped them, but you got to understand, they kick our butts. So we're trying to, you know, get a little fame ourselves. And then, you know, they're their own band, you know, and they're always going to have that shadow of being an extreme shadow. And to be honest with you, they have their own thing. And it's too bad that they're related, because that's always going to haunt them. But those guys have their own.
Yeah, they're a great band. Originally from Boston, they moved out to L.A., and they're doing demos now, and they're probably 6 months away
from
getting signed.
From them.
Well, that's it.
Aww.
Doesn't it go so fast?
Aww.
This is the tearjerker ending we were looking for. That's all for this edition of Rockline on MTV. Be here next week when our guest is Color Me Bad.
We've got one of the biggest bands in the world at the moment to kick us off on the show tonight. From Boston, this is Extreme Wholehearted.
Segundos, Steve Vai ha dejado el escenario del Auditorio de la Cartuja sevillana. Le veremos luego al final del concierto en esas jam sessions especiales que cierran cada una de estas noches del festival Leyendas de la Guitarra. Brian May, el guitarrista de Queen, está presentando a la siguiente estrella, que es Nuno Betancourt, el guitarrista de Stream, un grupo que está revolucionando el mundo del rock, incluyendo nuevos sonidos que hasta hace pues no mucho tiempo parecían bastante ajenos al universo del heavy metal, sonidos de funky y de rap, y también baladas, porque precisamente una balada, que será lo que escuchemos a continuación, les ha convertido en grandes estrellas en las últimas semanas en todo el mundo del rock. Además, el cantante de su grupo, Cherokee, está a su lado para interpretar esta canción, que es More Than Words, más que palabras.
This one goes out to Pat and Paul. You got it already. Saying I love you is not the words I want to hear from you. It's not that I want to not say, but if you only knew how easy it would be to show.
More Than War, el éxito comercial de Stream, pero desde luego una canción que no da la medida de la música excitante que practica este grupo, cuyo guitarrista estábamos viendo hace unos instantes y será el protagonista de los próximos minutos aquí en el escenario del Auditorio de la Cartuja de Sevilla. Nuno Betancourt, que es portugués y forma parte de una banda que ha sabido mezclar el rock duro con los sonidos funk bailables. Él ha anunciado que va a hacer una pequeña improvisación a la que luego se irán sumando algunos de los músicos que hasta el momento ya hemos visto, como Steve Ferrone, Brian May, Rick Wakeman, Neil Murray. Get the Funk Out. Esto sí que es el sonido de Extreme, música convulsiva con mezcla de estilos. La música de este grupo, como la de Living Color, Anthrax, Urban Dance Squad o Fishbone, por poner solo un ejemplo, que marcan cuál va a ser el camino que el rock va a seguir en los próximos años. Y por eso también...
Hacelo por mí, la primera banda internacional de las miles que van a venir este año. La primera es Extreme.
Speak English, yeah.
Yeah, I do.
Veronica?
I know.
Hey, come here. Hey, you.
Hi.
Bueno, preguntarles, bueno, ¿cuánto hace que llegaron a la Argentina? ¿Cómo están hasta ahora?
How long have you been here? For how long have you been here? And how are you now, right now?
How long have we been here?
Yeah.
We've been here in the studio for about 4 hours, but we've been in South America for about 3 or 4 days right now.
Hace 3 o 4 días que están acá en Sudamérica. Hace 4 horas que están acá en el estudio con nosotros.
¿Sabían que ya agotaron toda una función rápidamente, que va a haber una nueva el 22?
The first show you will do, there are no more tickets for this show, and you will do another one?
We're doing two shows. We're going to do two shows. Show. Yeah.
Van a hacer dos shows. Wow.
What, three shows?
¿Tres shows van a hacer?
No, three. Okay. Pregúntale, ellos son de un lugar como Boston, ¿no? Que son bastante sesudos. Ellos son todos músicos así, como muy experimentados, muy sesudos.
You are from Boston, right? That people are like, you know, high class. And you are like rock.
Yeah.
How does it combine that?
We're just regular guys. People who treat us nice, we treat them nice.
Sorry?
The people that are nice to us, we're nice to them.
Las personas son amables con ellos o son amables. Ellos son personas comunes.
Okay, después seguimos charlando. ¿Por qué no hacen More Than War ahora? Your hit. Sí.
Come and play. You do More Than War?
Sure.
Okay.
Right. No, keep going.
Yeah. Okay. You pueden. Extreme sonando aquí en Hacelo por mí. Y el hit que lo llevó al puesto número uno en los Estados Unidos, More Than War.
More than words to show you feel
that your love for me is real. What would you say if I took those words away? Then you couldn't make things new. Just by
No tengo traductor. Bueno, se fue Verónica. You know speak English, Spanish? No.
Portuguese, not Spanish.
Poquitito. You are Portugal.
What are they saying?
Ole, extreme, extreme. Okay, thank you. Good luck for your shows in the opera.
Eh?
Okay. Thank you. Bye bye. Extreme entonces estuvo acá. Gracias a la gente de Pro Música por habernos dado los instrumentos para que toquen los chicos de acá.
If my heart was torn,
We love you. We thank you very much.
Try to sing it for seeing you. Everybody get the fun. fishing, occupy my time. Priorities are cold things of mine. I half an ounce or one step behind. This inner peace I've yet to find. A river.